It was 1994 when the future of nearly 23,000 acres of the South Mountains fell on shaky ground as timber companies sought to purchase nearly 18,000 forested acres to clear cut. At stake were the river-laced forests of what was then called the Rawlins Tract, which joined the spine of the South Mountain Range for 14 miles, spanning both Rutherford and Cleveland counties. The Morganton watershed covered nearly 5,000 acres to the north and was seen as the wild backyard for Burke County residents who wanted to keep it that way. At the threat of impending deforestation, citizens united to change the course for this land.
There was already an existing state park that was about 5,000 acres at the time, and we knew we could possibly build from that park to create what we hoped would be about a 50,000 acre area of protected land.
There was a groundswell of people that were very instrumental in this happening. The people campaigned for it, and they wrote letters, and they were very involved in this becoming a park.
And so it was that the South Mountains Coalition was born in an attempt to steer the fate of these two tracts toward conservation.
We were starting from scratch. This small group of locally based concerned citizens did not understand or know even at that time really what a land trust was. We approached the Nature Conservancy's North Carolina chapter to see if they would help. And after period of discussion, they began to realize that this was also something that was important, but it had never been done in the state of North Carolina, the acquisition of a tract as large as 18,000 acres.
In order to protect the thousands of acres surrounding the existing state park, the group began working with botanists to document the incredible array of plant and animal species on the tract, thus establishing its conservation value.
One of the things about the South Mountain that's so unique is the diversity that occurs here. The biodiversity is fairly great. It ranks among the top locations in North Carolina that has a significant number of plant and animal biota that occur here. One of the other things about the state park here is the water quality. You have several large streams like the Jacobs Fork and the Henry River that originate here in the South Mountain State Park and flow out. And with the protection that is ongoing in the state park, you're able to conserve and protect that watershed and allowing for cleaner natural streams to flow out of the state park.
The treasure trove of biodiversity discovered enabled the Rawlins Tract to be categorized as a nationally significant natural heritage area, creating a catalyst for conservation. These efforts, combined with a mass media campaign and backed by partnerships with the state and the Nature Conservancy, finally brought the Rawlins Tract into the spotlight. Through perseverance and partnerships, funding soon followed.
We were beginning to work with our state agency partners to apply for state funding from our natural resource trust funds, including the Clean Water Management Trust Fund. And we were beginning to make friends with our state legislators and the governor because we knew we would need a special appropriation to execute a purchase of this magnitude.
The South Mountains Coalition eventually became Foothills Conservancy, and expanded their vision for conservation to include the Blue Ridge Mountains and rolling foothills, spanning 8 counties of western North Carolina.
Our relationship with the Foothills Conservancy has been invaluable. They have helped us to acquire critical tracts of land that are so important to the protection of the watersheds, protection of our wildlife, to add land for people to be able to recreate and to come back to nature.